Hello students, how are you all? Hope all of you are well. In the previous video, I had explained to you about the class 8 science chapter number 1 complete NCERT solution, right? That was a little bit long video also, but I hope that all of you have written. If you have not written, then please take screenshots, and whenever you would like to write, then please write all that answers. Today I am going to explain you chapter 2 NCERT complete solution. Similar as I have shown you in the chapter number 1, each and every answer I am going to explain it, and after that you have to write all the answers very carefully in your notebook, because these answers are very helpful for unit test 1. Got it, student? So let's start writing NCERT chapter number 2, microorganisms NCERT solution. Let's start. So let's start, students. Science NCERT grade 8 means standard 8, chapter number 2, microorganisms, friends and foe. Encompasses all the essential concept of the microorganism. The chapter starts with the basic definition of microorganisms. Microbes, for the understanding of microorganisms, is developed with the help of two activities, which shows the presence of microorganisms in water and soil. Classifications of microorganisms into bacteria, fungi, protozoa and algae, along with the viruses, is included. Means these are the few hints of the chapter, that what we have to read in this chapter, and after understanding about the microorganism, friends and foe, for the sake of understanding, let's go ahead. You can see friendly microorganism and harmful microorganism. The following uses of friendly microorganisms are discussed, as making of curd and butter, increasing soil fertility, large-scale production of alcohol, wine and acetic acid, fermentation, as antibiotics, as vaccines, cleaning the environment. Harmful microorganisms are called pathogens. I have asked you one question about the pathogens. What are pathogens and what are they called? So they are especially communicable diseases, especially for the food preservations, and the microorganisms which are friends and foe. So the topic in this chapter covered are microorganism, where do microorganism lives, microorganism and us, harmful microorganisms, food preservations, nitrogen fixation and nitrogen cycles. So these was our chapter's detail. Now let's start the fill in the blanks of this exercise. All of you are having NCERT PDF. If you are not having NCERT PDF, then I will give you a link of NCERT, that how to download NCERT textbook, right? So first of all, let's go towards the questions. Microorganisms can be seen with the help of a, can you tell me what will be the answer? Microscope. All of you have seen also microscope, right? Blue green algae fixed with, can you tell me, blue green algae fixed dash directly from the air to enhance the fertility of soil. Alcohol is produced with the help of dash. Cholera is caused by, see, all the answers also I have written. If you have NCERT textbook, or if you are not having, then please write only answers also in your notebook. So you can see all that four questions answered. Microorganism can be seen with the help of a microscope. Blue-green algae fixed with nitrogen directly from air to enhance the fertility of soil. Alcohol is produced with the help of yeast. Cholera is caused by bacteria. Now we are moving towards the take the correct answer, means MCQ. Yeast is used in the production of sugar, alcohol, hydrochloric acid or oxygen. Second question is, the following is an antibiotic: sodium bicarbonate, septomycin, alcohol or yeast. Carrier of malaria causing protozoan is female anopheles mosquito, cockroach, housefly or butterfly. The most common carrier of communicable disease is ant, housefly, dragonfly, spider. The bread of Italy dough rises because of heat, grinding, growth of yeast cells, kneading. The process of conversion of sugar into alcohol is called nitrogen fixation, molding, fermentation, infection. See, all the answers I have given here. So you can write answers from here. The first answer, the yeast is used in the production of. The yeast is used in the production of. Can you tell me what will be the right answer? Where the yeast are being used, sugar, alcohol and hydrochloric acid or oxygen. Yeast means what, you know, which is specially found in the bread and molds. So it will be specially in the alcohols and amantics. The following is an antibiotic. Which is antibiotic? Can you tell me? See all the red color lines you can see, these are the right answer. Streptomycin. Third one, carrier of malaria using protozoan, mosquito. The most common carrier of communicable disease is housefly. The bread of Italy, dough rises because of growth of yeast cells. The process of conversion of sugar into alcohol is called fermentation. So these was our MCQ answers. Now we are moving towards the match the following. Match the columns in the column 1 and 2. You can just read the questions and you can go ahead. So here I have written the answers also. You can just copy these answers in your notebook. Bacteria causing cholera. Rhizobium fixing nitrogen. Lactobacillus setting of curd. Yeast baking of bread. So these were our MCQ answers. Sorry, not MCQ, made the following answers. Now we are moving towards ahead. The two made the following: a protozoan causing malaria and a virus causing AIDS. Question number 4. Can microorganism be seen with the naked eyes? If not, how can they be seen? It can be seen or not. First of all, the question is that. And if it is not, then how can be this seen? Microorganisms are too small to be seen through the naked eyes. They can be seen with the help of a magnifying glass or microscope. For examples, fungus that grow on bread is so small that it can be seen only with the help of a magnifying glass or microscope. Next question. What are the major groups of microorganisms? The 5 major groups of microorganisms are bacteria. They are single cell disease causing microorganism. They can be spiral or rod shaped. Fungi, they are mostly multicellular diseases causing microbes. Bread molds are a common example of fungi. Protozoa, they mainly include organisms such as amoeba, plasmodium, etc. Can be unicellular or multicellular. Algae, they include multicellular photosynthetic organisms such as Spirogyra and Chlamydomonas, etc. Name the microorganism which can fix atmospheric nitrogen in the soil. Can you tell me which microorganism can fix nitrogen into the soil? Bacteria such as Rhizobium and certain blue-green algae present in the soil can fix atmospheric nitrogen and convert it into usable nitrogen compounds. These nitrogenous compounds can be easily utilized by the plants for the synthesis of plants, proteins and other compounds. So these microorganism can specially fix into the atmospheric nitrogen into the soil. Rhizobium can fix, or blue algae present in the soil can fix the atmospheric nitrogen to convert the nitrogenous compound. That nitrogenous compound can be used by the plants. Got it? Now we are moving towards the next question. Question number 7. Write 10 lines on the usefulness of microorganism in our life. Means you have to write the importance of microorganisms. What are the importance of microorganisms in our life? Here I have written also importance of microorganisms. You can see they are used in wine making, baking, pickling and other food making processes. Alcoholic fermentation by yeast is widely used in the preparation of wine and bread. Bacterium lactobacillus promotes the formation of curd. Microbes are used to reduce pollution. For example, the decomposers such as bacteria and fungi break down the dead bodies and excreta to form inorganic compounds which can be absorbed by plants. They are used to increase the soil fertility by fixing the atmospheric nitrogen with the help of bacterium, rhizobium and some other blue-green algae. Microbes also play an important role in the preparation of medicines, antibiotics and chemicals. Antibiotics are chemicals produced by microorganisms to kill bacteria. Streptomycin, for example, is an antibiotic. Certain microbes are also used in the form of biological treatment of sewage and industry influence. Now we are moving towards the question number 8. Write a short paragraph on the harms caused by microorganisms. Can you tell me? Harmful effects of microorganisms, that was the useful effects, and now we are going to write harmful effects. So these are all the answers you can write in your notebook. If you have any type of doubt, then you can comment your doubt into the comment box section. And I hope that all of you are understanding that what the question wants to say. If you are still having a doubt, you can ask to me. You can write these answers in your notebook. So let's start. Harmful effects of microorganisms. Microorganism causes disease in animals, for example in humans. Bacteria causes disease such as tuberculosis, cholera, typhoid, etc. In cattle, the foot and mouth disease is caused by a virus. Also, several microbes cause diseases in plants. For example, the productivity of wheat, orange, apple, etc. is reduced due to the microbial diseases in plants. Certain microbes on entering into our body produce toxic substances. Toxic means poisonous substances. This leads to food poisoning. Some microorganisms such as fungus spoil our food. For example, bread, when left unused under the moist condition, gets spoiled by fungus, producing a white cotton-like growth on the bread. So this was a short paragraph which are harmful for caused by microorganisms. What are antibiotics and what are the precautions must be taken while taking antibiotics? Very, very important question. I hope that you should know this answer, because each and everybody nowadays is suffering from some of the virus, and scientists are making these antibiotics. What are antibiotics? Antibiotic are medicines produced by certain microorganisms to kill other disease-causing microorganisms. Means when one microorganism spread another disease, so with the help of these antibiotics by some certain microorganism, they will be killed, and it can especially be an antibiotic or antidote of that disease. These medicines are commonly obtained from bacteria and fungi. Streptomycin, tetracycline, penicillin, etc. are the common antibiotics. What are the precautions taken while taking antibiotics? The precautions to be taken while using antibiotics are, first, antibiotics should be taken under the supervision of a well-qualified doctor. Means not, we should not take any type of medicines by unknown doctor. Means jhola chhap doctor, if had prescribed us, we should not take. So we should take, antibiotics should be taken under the supervision of a well-qualified doctor. Course means intake of antibiotics should be completed as per prescriptions given by the doctor. Means you should not leave as the one tablet you have taken and you have leave that I am okay. No, as the doctor had prescribed you, according to that you should take medicines. Antibiotics should be taken in the right amount at the right time. A wrong dose of antibiotics makes the drug ineffective. Also, excessive consumptions of drug may kill the useful bacteria present in our body. So we must take drugs as the doctor has prescribed on a prescribed time. Means whatever the time they have suggested, and that time only. If you are taking at the wrong time, then it can harm your body. So as you have seen, these are the few precautions to be taken using the antibiotic. So this was our chapter number 2, microorganism NCRT solution. If you are having any doubt during this solution, you can take a screenshot also, as I'm showing you all the answers. So please take screenshot. This is the answer number 9, right? You can take the screenshot of answer number 9. Taken. Now we are moving ahead. Now you can take the screenshot of answer number 8. Right? You have taken. Now we are moving. You can take the answer number 7 screenshot. See, there are two parts of 7. It starts from here. Microorganism, take this first part, and now you can take the second part. So you can see both the parts answer, you can write it very carefully, and after then you can take the screenshot of question number 6. Now you can take the screenshot of question number 5. Now you can take the screenshot of question number 4, question number 3. All these answers of this match the following, this and this. Now we are moving towards question number 2. All the red line I have already explained you about the MCQ. If you are still having any type of doubt, then you can please drop your doubt into the comment box sections. Got it? I hope all of you have written these all the answers in your notebook. If you are having any type of doubt, then please drop your doubt into the comment box section so I can improve from the next video. That's all for today. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to like and subscribe. Share this video with your friends. And please, please, please don't forget to write these answers in your notebook. Thank you. Thank you very much.